In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. Today, our story will be about Saint Moses the Strong. We call him strong because he repented a strong repentance. At the beginning of his life, Moses was the slave of an important man. But after committing many crimes, his master banished him, and he went and joined a group of thieves. Because of his bad character and great physical strength, they chose him as their leader. Moses would proudly say, "I am Moses, the gang leader. No one is more powerful than me." Moses always questioned and said, "Who is the true God? Is it the Son who gives us light? But no, the sun always goes down at night. It can't be. Could it be the moon that shines greatly at night? But that can't be it either. The moon disappears in the morning. Who are you? And what's your name?" Then Moses heard a voice saying to him, "Go to the monastery, and the monks there will tell you who the true God is." When Moses went to the monastery, Saint Isidore approached him and said, "Who are you? And what are you doing here?" Moses answered and said, "My name is Moses, and I heard that you worship the true God. So I came to learn about him." Father Isidore took him to the church and said to him, "This is God's house. But before you enter, you must leave your weapon outside." Moses indeed did as Father Isidore told him. When they entered the church, Father Isidore said to Moses, "When we enter church, we bow in front of the altar and make the sign of the cross and raise our hands and say, 'Our Father.'" Moses then tried to do as he said. At the moment, Moses felt God's grace and mercy fill his heart. Then Moses asked Father Isidore to baptize him so he can become Christian. Soon after, Father Isidore baptized him and anointed him with the holy maroon oil. After being baptized, Moses stood in front of the monks in the church and said, "I am a sinner. I murdered many people, stole many times, and did awful sins. I am a sinner. Pray for me, fathers." While Moses was confessing his sins, Saint Macarius saw an angel holding a black color board filled with the sins that Moses committed. Whenever Moses confessed a sin, the angel would erase it off the board. After Moses became a Christian, Father Isidore told him, "You now are free to go and live with Jesus Christ." Saint Moses answered him and said, "No, Father, I wish to stay here and become a monk." Father Isidore tried to explain to Moses that his decision is not easy, but Saint Moses insisted on staying. In the time passing, Father Isidore ordained Moses as a monk. At the beginning of his monastic life, Saint Moses experienced many bad thoughts that came from the devil. He would go to Father Theodore and say, "Peace to you, Father Theodore. The demons keep reminding me of my old and sinful life." Father Isidore advised Saint Moses to stay up all night and pray. Saint Moses went back to his cell and did as Father Isidore told him. But his thoughts still bothered him. Then he went back again to Father Isidore and he told, "What do you see in the west?" Saint Moses said, "I see demons that are prepared for battle." Father Isidore asked him again, "What do you see in the east?" Moses said, "A greater number of holy angels, also ready for fighting. These angels were praising God and say, 'Holy, holy, holy, Lord, of hosts.'" Father Isidore explained to Moses that the angels of the Lord are sent to defend us against the demons. Saint Moses would use his physical strength to get up at night and fill water for his brethren monks. After a while living in the monastery, Saint Moses became a father to over 500 monks. The fathers would always take his advice and listen to him. When he became really old, there was an attack on the monastery and he was martyred. What can we learn from the story of Saint Moses? God accepts the sinner's repentance. Also, we should not judge anybody, but rather pray for them. May the holy blessing of Saint Moses be with us all. Amen. Pray for me and see you next time. Bye.